This tutorial is for beginners. It will show you the basic steps to design a roof parallel PV system in PVSOL Premium. It will take you from the very start to the final simulation. After starting PVSOL, you will see the welcome page. Here you can either start a new project or open an existing one. Directly open one of your recent projects. Or have a look at some example projects to get an idea of the possibilities of PVSOL. By left-clicking the button, we will be directed to the project data page. You can always switch between the different steps of your project by either left-clicking the arrow buttons or the speed button directly. On this page, you can add project-related information that will be shown in the final presentation. It is also possible to add your company logo. Done with this, we can switch to the next page. First, we choose which kind of system we want to simulate. In this tutorial, we use a grid-connected PV system with electrical appliances and battery systems. For accurate irradiation and temperature data, you can choose from over 8,000 locations worldwide. There is also the option to create new locations in the climate data module Meteosyn by clicking on the globe symbol. PVSOL Premium users can choose between two design options, 2D and 3D. By clicking this checkbox, you can switch between those two. In this tutorial, we will plan a 3D system. For that, we keep the default option and go to the next page. On the consumption page, you can import your own load profile or select an existing load profile. Click Add Consumption to see the different options. We now move to the 3D design page. We open the 3D visualization with the Edit button. In a new project, we can choose between several initial options. Import your own 3D model or choose from pre-made structures that can be modified later. It is also possible to use maps, satellite imagery, or floor plans from which you can easily extrude buildings. For this tutorial, we select Map section from the drop-down menu and then click on New Map section. In the pop-up window, we can choose between different map providers such as Google, Bing, or local map services. We enter our address details, zoom in on the building, and click on Select. The scale and orientation of the map section are automatically adopted. Now click on the Start button to begin the 3D design. The 3D visualization starts in the object view. Here we see the open space with the selected map section from a bird's eye view. The labeling on the edges and the compass in the right corner help with orientation. We can now use the 3D polygon tool to draw the outline of our building. To do this, we click on the corners of the building in a clockwise direction and define the base area. Now press the Enter key to leave the base area and draw the corresponding ridge. We then press the Escape key to leave the overall drawing mode. Now right-click on the marked area. Here we have the option to make the surface perpendicular. With another right click, we can extrude the building as a 3D object. The hipped roof is automatically recognized due to the ridge. Some parameters of the building, such as the height of the eaves and the roof pitch, can be entered here and confirmed with OK. Using the drop-down menus at the top, you can drag and drop additional objects such as houses, trees, and walls. For this design, we will add two trees. If you want to change the properties of your objects, just double-click on them and change the values in the dialog. We now copy the tree by right-clicking and copying it. We now select the east side of the roof, right-click and then select Activate. First, we define the edge distances for our roof area and select standard values for non-mounted system. Shading objects such as chimneys or satellite dishes are available in the menu as predefined drag and drop models. We can edit these objects and enter blocking distances. Once we have finished the modeling of the environment, it is time to add the PV modules. There are two different types of module installation, the module coverage and the module mounting. Both can be installed on any active object. Since we want to install the PV modules on a hipped roof, we will use the roof parallel module coverage. First, we need to choose a module. Click on the button with the green plus sign and add the desired module from the database. Our system is now displayed in the upper left corner. There are three ways to place the modules on the roof. You can place a single module by drag and drop. You can fill an area by dragging a square with the mouse. Or you can cover the entire surface of the object with modules. We now calculate the shading frequency for our roof. If a module is shaded, we can delete it. We now switch to the western part of the roof by clicking on the arrow above the ridge. Again, we enter the edge distances in the object view and then cover the roof in the module coverage. The next step is to connect our PV modules to an inverter. This is done in the module configuration. It is possible to connect modules from different areas and surfaces. In this case, we have two roof areas, so we select the option Configure all unconfigured modules. In the upper left corner, we select both roof areas and click on Configure module areas together. We can see that they have a combined power of approximately 13 kilowatt peak. In the inverter selection, we can select the inverters we want to use for automatic configuration from the database. For example, you can filter by inverter company and by power rating. The green arrows show a range of possible inverters. By clicking on the Suggest Configuration arrow button, PVSOL automatically calculates the best configuration from the selected inverters. In the Select Configuration menu, you can also view other possible configurations. Of course, you can also make your own configuration in the main window. A click on the OK button applies the configuration to your system. Back in the 3D design panel, we can see our inverter with the two MPPTs. Below we can choose the direction, the starting point and the course of the string layout. We can then view and modify the string layout in the cable plan view. In the last step, we adopt the data. In the next dialog, press OK to start the shading simulation. We now move to the battery system page. First, we select our inverter brand. We then add a compatible battery system. The cables page allows us to define the total cable loss or enter more detailed information. For example, we can enter specific cable lengths or add circuit symbols. The plans and parts page allows you to view, print and export a technical drawing of your system. You can add a legend and a drawing space and export it to PDF, PNG or SVG. On the financial analysis page, you can define the financial aspects of your project. The detailed parameters can be configured with the edit button. Feed-in tariffs for several countries are included in the database. And of course, you can always add your own tariffs. The design process is now complete and the project can be simulated. To do this, click on the speed button results. The results page features a variety of tables and diagrams to analyze and visualize the output of the simulation. All results are summarized in a customizable presentation that can be exported to MS Word or directly to PDF. The raw data can also be exported to MS Excel for further editing. This concludes our introduction. Thank you for watching. Visit our website to download your free 30-day trial version and explore the possibilities that PVSOL Premium has to offer.